Welcome to Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. We're standing on the westernmost portion of the continental United States, and we're headed down the foggy Lost Coast. Stay tuned, we got a really good dessert video coming up. Our trip down the Lost Coast has brought us here to AWA Campground near Petrolia on the Mattole River.
Hi, I'm Joni, the Teardrop Nanny. We're going to do a roll on the Mattole today, and we're going to be cooking you up a new recipe today.
Today's recipe is Pouding Chomeur. It's French-Canadian. It was developed in Quebec way back during the Depression.
Oui, monsieur. It's good stuff.
Which translates to poor man's cake. But it's really good and real simple. If you look below, you can click on more info to get the full printout of the recipe. I made up my dough yesterday and I stuck it in the ice chest overnight.
The dough contains 6 ounces of butter at room temperature, 1 cup of granulated sugar, 2 large eggs, 1 3/4 cups all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder. He combined the butter and sugar and added the eggs and things and flour. He refrigerated the dough for at least 24 hours. Now he's getting ready to add in the last couple ingredients, which are the maple syrup and the heavy cream.
Okay, what I need to do is I need to mix up the pure maple syrup and the heavy cream. What a great opportunity to use that special syrup that Mark from Indiana sent us for the IRG. The IRG maple syrup. So we're starting off with 2 cups of maple syrup. And 2 cups, or 1 pint, of heavy whipping cream. And I'm going to mix this up really good and then heat it up to a boil.
The syrup and the cream mixture are being brought to a boil. And after it comes to a boil, he's going to take it and let it cool off.
Okay, one thing you want to keep stirring this for is when this stuff starts to boil, it really wants to foam up. So we're ready to cut this from the heat and set it aside and let it cool. I've taken my dough, separated it into 6 separate balls. And I'm going to put 21 coals on top and 7 underneath. I'm going to bake this for about a half hour, but as soon as I get the coals on, I'm going to pour that syrup mixture back over it. Okay, I'm going to pour the syrup and heavy whipping cream mixture over this. And this is going to bake for approximately 1/2 hour. All right, it's been on for just about a half hour. Here comes the money shot. Hope it turned out. Let's take a look. Oh, yeah. Guy Mazzio, we're going to be calling you in a few minutes.
Look at those little shapes. They look like little corn candy. Smells great. We're making tracks now, and we're heading to the Dutch Oven Gathering. This is a group of the Fortuna Dutch Oven Society who we meet with and camp about 5 to 6 times a year and have regular dogs throughout the year. So let's join them in. Come see what's for dinner. Oh. Hey Marvin, what time is it?
It is 20 after.
Dinner time.
Time to eat.
Time to eat, yeah, there you go.
Okay, so there's plates in here. And...
First man, Larry, tell me what you thought of the pudding chomeur.
No, it was good. It was great.
Did it need more sugar?
Two more cups.
What'd you think of the pudding chomeur?
I ate it first.
Life's uncertain. Eat
it's
dessert.
Too short. Yep.
Eat dessert first.
And don't drink cheap wine.
That's right.
A gray color?
Former club president Marvin, what'd you think of the
pudding? No, I'm not the president anymore.
I said former president Marvin. What do you think of the pudding chomeur?
I didn't get any of it.
Why not? That's your own fault.
Oh, well then I is there any left?
I don't know. Well, we've decided to take the southerly swing home here in the great state of Jefferson. In fact, we haven't even left Humboldt County this weekend. We hope you enjoyed this recipe. It's easy, it's simple, and it tastes really good. I'd like to thank my friend Guy Mazzio for turning me on to it.
I'm Joni. Join us for another webisode. Happy trails to you. And remember,
it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.